Now Shivaprakasham Pillai is asking, is there any difference between waking or dreaming? And Dharaman Maharshi replies, other than dreaming is short and waking is longer, there is no difference. And then he explains that just like when we are awake, everything seems so real and it seems like we are the body and we are interacting. And just like that, in the dream, mind takes on to a different body and then everything seems very real in the dream also, right? So in that way, waking and dreaming is not very different. And then he says in both of these states, there are forms, there are names and there are thoughts, right? So waking and dreaming is not different. It is same. Other than the dreaming is short and the waking is longer. So this is being said from the subjective point of view, right? From the experience point of view, from the point of view of, what we are experiencing. When we experience the waking state and versus what when we experience the dreaming state, from the point of view of our experiencer, it is the same in that sense, right? In terms of reality, of course, that waking and dreaming has a difference in sense. In the waking, I am not the only one who's seeing the world, right? Every other person has also seeing the same thing that I am seeing, right? In the dream, I am seeing the only world that I am seeing. So this is important. That this is being talked from the subjective point of view. It is not talked from the objective point of view of this is dream and this is waking and they are the same in objective sense. But from subjective sense, it is the same. And that's what Raman Maharshi is saying. From the subjective point of view, when we are in the dream, there is forms. There is a body, right? The mind takes on to a different body. And there is this form, name, thoughts. All these things are there in the dream as well, right? In that sense, when we are in the real world, we are again dealing with the same entities. We are dealing with the form and name and we are dealing with thoughts and all the same entities that we are dealing in the dreaming state, right? So in that sense, from the experiencer point of view, from the point of view of a subject, they are the same, right? They are the same. Only difference is the waking is longer and the dreaming is short, right? And the waking sort of continues. In the waking, in the dreaming, once it ends, there's a new dream, right? The dream doesn't continue, but in the waking state, a sense of continuity is there, right? Because the frame is the same. When I wake up, it is the same frame. But in the dream, when we wake up, there's a different frame. There's a different setting and all these things, right? So in that sense, subjective point of view, there is no difference. And from the experiencer point of view, there is no difference. Because the experiencer is experiencing what? He's seeing the form, he's seeing the thoughts, and he's naming these forms. And the same thing he's doing in the waking state also, right? He's seeing this form, he's seeing that, he's naming all these different forms, he's experiencing the thoughts, right? So they are the same from that angle. They're the same from that angle. And if we change the context a little bit and we see, generally we dream for like a small period of time and the waking period is longer and then we dream for a small period of time, right? But for the thought experiment point of view, let's say, if we wake up only for 2 hours and we dream for 22 hours, right? And our dreams are, let's say, for some reason, continuous. They don't break. So next day when I go to the, sleep, I will restart my dream from there. And then I wake up and then I see this and then I go back and then I restart my dream from where it ends from the last time, just from my experimental point of view. In that case, we will say this waking state is an unreal one and the dreaming state is the real one, right? Because we have this sense of continuity that is going on and that is the longer one. So it can be changed. It can be, our perception can be changed. Which one is real, right? The dream is real or the real world? This waking state is real, right? Because we are experiencing both. And we are saying one is not real and one is real, right? Very interesting. It's because Raman Maharshi and the Vedanta and all these systems are more subjective science. So they have observed this phenomena and asked these kind of questions quite deeply. What exactly is the difference from the point of view of subject, right? From the point of view of subject, there seems to be same. It's only the difference in the like amount, how long this is, how long that is, right? And the sense of continuity of the dream. So it doesn't mean like we start considering the world is now dream and all that. But Raman Maharshi is trying to separate the subject from these different states, right? Again, this is in the Upanishad that there are three states, dreaming, deep sleep, and the waking state. But they want to separate, there is a subject who is experiencing these three different states, right? So that we don't identify with it. The problem again is this ignorance that I am the body, ignorance of the sort that we are going through, that they are trying to break out, that they are trying to break out for us. Like, what is the difference between dreaming and what is the difference between waking, right? Subject is the same. Somebody is experiencing that dream as well, right? Somebody is experiencing this waking state as well. And somebody is experiencing the deep sleep as well, right? So they want to separate this self, right? They call it the fourth, the turiya. They want to separate the self from these three states so that we can see more clearly what we exactly are, right? Who am I? Again, this question, who am I? So, yeah, interesting answer. Waking and dreaming from subjective standpoint is the same, right? Only difference is this one is longer and one is shorter.